Okay. Celebrity high-low game. The celebrity that wants to perhaps remake, restart Roadhouse. Any guesses?
I got two.
All right.
I was thinking this could be a Chris Pratt vehicle.
Ooh.
From like the guy from Guardians of the Galaxy, Jurassic World. I could see him. Has some humor to him, too.
I'm going to say lower, but close. Okay. It's slightly lower than Chris Pratt.
Ice Cube.
Higher than Ice Cube.
Ryan Reynolds.
Lower than Ryan Reynolds. But again, on that same plane, I think he's close.
Paul Rudd.
Whew. Higher than Paul Rudd. I think.
Sexiest man alive, Paul Rudd.
Yeah, he just won Sexiest Man Alive now. Did you hear Paul yesterday? Paul Rudd wins Sexiest Man Alive, and he's so funny.
He is a funny guy.
And everybody says about him, he looks so young. He really does. It's amazing, and I like him. Well,
you know, the big thing that the internet did last year, apparently, was, and it's shocking, apparently, Paul Rudd was the same age now as Wilford Brimley when he was in Cocoon.
Correct. That's right. That's right.
I mean, when you see them side by side.
That's right.
It's shocking.
It's how people age, you know, how they take care of their bodies.
A lot of it's genetics, but
taking care of your body, to me, you know, that kind of
Is
thing.
That why you do what you do?
Exactly. I want to live to be 100. B, I want to look better, and I want to take care of my body. Paul Rudd, typically very funny with this, when he won People's Sexiest Man Alive.
It's going to change a lot. I'm hoping now that I finally get invited to some of these sexy dinners with, you know, Clooney and Pitt and B. Jordan. And I figure I'll probably be on a lot more yachts. I'm excited to expand my yachting life. And I'll probably try to get better at brooding with really soft light. I'd like to ponder. I'd like to be a lot more inward. I think this is gonna help me be a little bit more inward and mysterious. And so I'm looking forward to that.
All right, that's Paul Rudd. He won People's Sexiest Man Alive yesterday. I think the celebrity that is considering remaking Roadhouse is slightly larger name. I'm going to say just bigger.
There goes Viggo Mortensen.
Higher than.
Hold on.
Yep.
I got it.
You got
it's
it?
Gotta be.
Yep.
The Rock.
No.
That'd be perfect. That
perfect vehicle for him, though.
I think this guy's lower than The Rock. Because I think The Rock is like the biggest star going right now. I mean, he's huge. I think this guy has won. I want to say he's won an Academy Award, or he's at least been nominated for an Academy. He's done some really deep stuff, and I know you all are huge fans of some of his movies.
Huh.
He seems to be pick and choose, though. I mean, he's not in a tremendous amount of movies. And
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Lower than Daniel Day. Lower than Daniel
Day. I'm running out of ideas.
I may need to start giving clues.
Ben Affleck?
I say a little bit lower,
okay.
On the but in that ballpark. Let me try and give a clue here.
Casey Affleck,
higher than Casey Affleck. Although he won an Academy Award.
Oh, did he?
I think
yeah,
so.
I think you're right.
For that really sad movie. Mm-hmm. This guy maybe got most famous for playing a gay man. I'll say that he played
McConaughey.
Not lower than McConaughey. Lower than McConaughey. He played a gay man in a really sad, difficult...
Nathan Lane.
No.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Brokeback Mountain.
Brokeback Mountain.
When you hit sad gay man.
I know. Higher than Nathan Lane. I was getting ready to say the saddest, most difficult gay movie of all time that Biggie called the comedy romp.
The feel-good comedy of whatever, 2010.
Well, as soon as you said sad gay man, because I'll be honest, when you first said played gay man, I had flamboyant, over-the-top gay man.
No, sad gay man.
Jake Gyllenhaal. Shocking.
Sad, leave it in, try to closet yourself gay man.
Mm-hmm.
And
in denial.
I think he's slightly bigger than Paul Rudd. Do you think?
I'd put them about equal.
It's close. It's very close, yeah.
Yeah.
I go just a little bit, because I think he's been like nominated for Best Actor.
He has, and you're right. He's had some movies that get Best Picture nominations.
A lot.
And he's had a few kind of stinkers, though, too.
Well, stinkers, but then there are also some where Gyllenhaal will do a movie, Nightcrawler, which we all love, that nobody really sees, that is a really great... I think he's a really, really good actor.
Super talent.
Absolutely right. Anyway, he wants to play the role that Patrick Swayze played.
The bouncer
in uh, in Roadhouse.
Boy, that's a bad movie.
Terrible. And I'm surprised that when I read it, I was like, really? He wants to redo
that?
Well,
my question for him, or for this, is he trying to take it in a more serious spin?
I don't know. That's a good question.
I don't think of him as a real comedic actor. I guess he's done some.
Maybe he just loved it and wants to redo it and be part of it. Who knows?
That's a strange thing to attach your name to. And Biggie's right. Did Ronda Rousey remake it, or was that just
I thought they were deep into talks.
I can't remember.
I don't remember.
This is back when she was leaving the UFC to become more of an action star.
That has not worked out for her.
No, and she tried WWE for a while, and that didn't go great. I think she popped back up. She has had a child, though, now, and she's married. And
yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I think she's still around, but...
not as much.
They had her pegged as a giant star, and that just did not work out.
It kind of fizzled out for her. There's a new song, too, that is out from ZZ Top's Billy Gibbons. We were just talking about Mariah Carey doing her partnering with McDonald's for Christmas. He's got a Christmas song called Jingle Bell Blues. See what you think of it. And this is Billy Gibbons by himself with ZZ Top. Remember when, was it Dusty Hill who died from ZZ Top? And you all said they went out on the road faster than any band ever after one of the band members had passed.
They went out, the ZZ Top regrouped and went out faster than the Wonders did the night they were on TV.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
When the bass player quit and went to Disneyland.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And the Wolfman took his place.
Exactly. The guy died, Dusty Hill died, and they were like...
they announced a tour.
The next day.
They were in the middle of it.
It's what he would want.
That's what they said. It's what he would want.
It was his last words.
But they made him say it.
What are you saying, Dusty? Go on tour! We will. For you.
Here's the Christmas song. Dashing through the snow on a one-horse open sleigh. Over the field we go. We've been laughing all the way. Bells on hot rods ring. Changing it up a little bit. Making spirits tight. For what fun it is to ride in a drop-top sled tonight. The lyrics are all about cars. Hot rod cars. Jingle Bell Blues by Billy Gibbons of ZZ Top.
I feel like this should be in a movie, like the opening of a movie about someone who hates Christmas like and loves to run it.
Like a Christmas Roadhouse. Yeah, or something. Yeah. That's a good point. I mean, pretty good. It's a
decent groove.
It's a little slow.
He's a little long in the tooth, but blues are all right.
Yeah, it's okay. It works out pretty well. The other person is making a little Christmas news today. You remember yesterday I was talking about, what's her name with the goop? She has the
Gwyneth Paltrow.
And she's selling a lot of sexual toys on her website and has said this is great for the holidays, great Christmas shopping. Not to be outdone, Dakota Johnson, who's in 50 Shades of Grey, says, I go one better. I've got some plugs, some butt plugs, perfect for the holiday season.
So she'll. If this was a card game, Gwyneth Paltrow says... or Dakota saying, I'll see your
vibrator.
Group vibrator and raise you a butt plug.
That's right.
A holiday themed one?
Yes, it's shaped like a Christmas tree.
Well, that's how they normally are shaped. So
it's colored like a Christmas tree. It's called the cone. And
it's peppermint mocha.
Yule log.
Body safe silicone made with only the finest materials and perfect as a Christmas present for your mate for the holidays. It's $30. She says,
what's that in your stocking over there, Steve? You have one left. I haven't opened your stocking yet.
Oh, my God. What are you doing? This is for a Christmas present. So it's dark evergreen and resembles a Christmas tree. She says it's perfect for bedroom festivities all during the holidays and anytime.
She must be getting paid a ton.
She's partnered with a company called Maud, and they do a lot of these types of items. If you go to Maud.com.
Her father's still alive.
I know.
I mean, that's something you advertise after your dad's gone.
But she might be too old then.
but she got famous parents.
I mean, they're young. They're I mean, they're what, 60s? They could live another 25 years. They could, Don Johnson, I bet he lives another 20 years.
Oh, God.
Then she's going to be too old. She's got to do it now.
So anything on the horizon, honey? Well, now that you bring it up, Dad, I'm being paid to endorse butt plugs.
Yeah, and she did.